So in this video, I'm going to play on a violin that has been on my wish list for quite a while. And it's a Viper violin by Mark Wood. And no, I did not buy this violin, but one of my subscribers did buy one. His name is Tarik, and he sent me a message asking me if I wanted to try it. Yes. And on top of that, he happens to live less than an hour away from me. So a date was quickly set and off I went. So let's see how that went. So when I arrived at Tarik's house, he showed me his Viper violin and it looks just awesome. And before we continue, here is some nice heavy metal stuff. And then it was my turn to try it. Viper violins don't have a shoulder rest or chin rest. The instrument is strapped around your body with a belt, and there's some sort of pedal on a stick thing that you put against the side of your body for stability. And it took quite some adjusting before it finally felt comfortable, but then I could have a go at it. So let's see how that went. Met een veel meer gitaarachtig geluid heeft hij eigenlijk, hè? Wat bellen is dat nog, zeg?
Want je weet ook hoe dat fretsysteem werkt, toch?
Dat je vinger erop moet, echt?
Ja, je moet hem erop spelen. Deze stip is dan de derde positie. Dit is dan de vierde.
Maar je merkt wel dat je dan de roep hoort als je omhoog gaat.
Ja, eigenlijk zou je ietsje minder druk dan moeten oefenen. Dan heb je dat.
So we just tried the Viper, and I see that your Viper has 5 strings.
Yes.
And why did you order one with 5 strings instead of 4? But you could also choose 6 or 7, right?
That's true, just because 6 and 7 is a bit too much for me.
But can imagine.
The thing is, like with the 5 strings, because I play a lot of metal stuff, and a lot of it is tuned in D standard or E standard, and the C string gives me some extra, just an extra low note. But you can also use an octave pedal.
Then you got a 5-string cello.
Yes, exactly.
Nice. And which color is your Viper?
At least according to the site, it's black cherry.
The thing that stands out mostly is that your Viper has frets.
You can order them with or without frets. And you even have special frets, they're called phantom frets. So you can see the inlays, but you cannot feel the frets at all. So that's also an option, but I decided to go for the frets.
Well, they feel a bit like guitar frets, and they are slightly lower on the side of the E string. I was so lucky to try this Viper, and I thought it would be easy, but...
No, not
it
at
wasn't.
All.
But I can imagine that if you get used to it, it gives a lot of freedom, because you don't have to clench your violin with your neck.
No, exactly.
Your chin, I mean.
No, but that's also the thing. Like, I have this instrument for 2 months now, but even now I'm still searching for the perfect setup, because there's so much freedom. You can put it like this, you can put it a bit further away, you can put it a bit towards your body, so... And you can also tilt it, like there's so many options.
And how long did you have to wait before it arrived?
Oh man, I had to wait so long, I had to wait for 2 years, but it was well
oh,
worth
boy.
it was well worth the wait.
You said to me that you want to do Twitch streams with it?
Yeah, and I'm going to stream mostly metal on the violin and then on the piano, because I also play piano.
Nice.
I'm going to play video game music mostly.
Video game music is awesome.
So like Final Fantasy, Kingdom Hearts, all that kind.
I'll put a link down below the video to your Twitch.
Sure.
Nice. Another reason I wanted to try this Viper in real life is because I would love to have one myself, but I wasn't sure yet if I would like how it feels. If I would ever get a Viper violin, I think I would get the pink one.
Pink one?
Bright Barbie pink. And I'm so not a pink girl, but I like the pink one. So this was the Viper demonstration. Thank you for letting me try this.
Yes, you're welcome.
It was strange, difficult, but very interesting. Thank you. And we're back. I'm very happy I had the chance to try an actual Viper violin. And it was surprisingly hard to play at first, because I'm of course not used to it. It felt a bit wobbly to me. But it was so awesome to not having to press the violin down with your chin, but just be able to look around and move freely. It felt just a bit rockstar-like. I can imagine why they call these rockstar violins, because yeah, you can do this. I've also learned, yet again, that having frets on a violin does not necessarily make playing it any easier. It's also still a challenge to play in tune, and having frets also means having to adjust your finger pressure when shifting. Beforehand, I thought that I would get home and place an order for a custom Viper myself straight away. But I don't think I will get myself one anytime soon. Maybe unless I would have band performances very often, or if I would join a rock band or metal band. I'm not seeing that happening very soon, but you never know. Do you like Viper violins? And if yes, let me know in the comments which color you think is the coolest. How many strings would you want if you could choose? And frets or no frets? Let me know, I'd love to hear it. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you next time.